Insidious.
Let's go, it's the Whitey Show.
Whitey Show.
If you're still watching after that, thank you. Insidious is not by the original director of the first two. It's by his, I believe, camera work guy. The guy who kind of did the shots and stuff that helped out, I think. And I don't know his name. Sorry. It's a Japanese name. I don't want to butcher it and then get slaughtered in the comments. It is an interesting movie. It's kind of better than two. How does the third one be better than a second one in a franchise? I don't know, but it does. It continues the story in a way, but it's a prequel to the first two. It really focuses on a different family and everything, and I really like that. And you get the backstory to our favorite ghost hunter. My God, I forgot her name again. I need to really have a list of the names and the actors. But yeah, it's the lady from the first two, the one who is the basically one able to go into the further, and she is here to help a new family. And overall, that's what the story is. It's a totally different demon. Totally different story. It has nothing to do with the first two, really. You could kind of watch it by itself, and that's a good thing in my opinion. And it's kind of like a way to really get to know where these characters, or at least the main character who deals with these demons, come from. What I really liked is the story was the main aspect, and that's what I like about all the Insidious. With horror movies, they really just throw gore and rah. But what I really did love is the fact that it's a story. You actually care about these characters because you actually feel like they are real people. They're not just characters used to die. Actually, almost, does anybody really die? One person dies in this movie. All the acting is pretty good. I'd say the best are definitely, I promise I will get actors' names. I will print it out and put it here. Really, the main protagonist, the female, the ghost hunter who's in the first two, is phenomenal. She's a step above what you expect in most horror movies. And then you have the young girl who's also the star and the main character of the family that they're handling. And she's also really good. She has this creepy sense to her when she needs to be, but she's also just really likable. And that's important because most horror characters you hate. So overall, I really did enjoy the story aspect of this. I also really like these shots. Everything is pretty creepy. There's not a lot of CGI. Thank God. Everything feels like actual makeup. And you could still be scary with makeup. I know Hollywood. I know. Loved the design of a lot of the demons, especially a certain demon at the end. So yeah, I enjoyed the story and I enjoyed the fact that everything was creepily shot, and that's perfect for Insidious. And I also love my favorite thing. I like jump scares, but I hate fake jump scares where, you know, for some reason a fucking cat or dog appears and it's a loud banging because of the floorboard, or your friend, for some reason, when it's super quiet, comes behind you like, "Hey, what's up, man? Bitch, why are you screaming?" But yeah, I really love that the jump scares were actually something bad happening. And I don't mind jump scares because they, you know, they're good to shock you. And I enjoyed getting, that's how I sound when I get scared. I'm gonna stop. In some aspects. One, and this is probably the biggest thing, it's kind of boring sometimes. Which is weird, because I am usually never bored in horror movies, but I really was bored at some points in this movie. Sometimes the backstories I didn't care about, and the mom thing was a little, not enough emotion, not enough care. Also, at times there is some awful acting. The dad, who I really do enjoy in other stuff, especially Shameless, he was just okay in here, so he didn't bother me much, but that kid, the little brother, right there, that was better acting than that kid. It was bad. He was awful. He was so bad it hurt my eyes when I saw him. No, I'm just kidding. But yeah, it's just some of the acting really took away from it. And again, a lot of jump scares. So if you're not a jump scare type of guy, you want more suspense and thrill, mostly it's just jump scares. A lot of jump scares. A lot of none of that is jump scare. Like that. And again, you're hating me. Overall, did I like Insidious Chapter 3? Yes! I am surprised. I would say I would recommend it to horror fans. Would I recommend it to anybody? No. If you didn't like Insidious 1, you're just crazy. But if you didn't like Insidious 1, then you're not going to like 3. But if you did like Insidious 1 and thought 2 wasn't that great, you might really like 3. I thought that. Insidious 2 was just okay, whereas this I thought I could actually say is good. It's good horror fun, and I really enjoyed it. I actually cared about the characters, and I really enjoyed the actual makeup of a lot of these demons, and it was creepy. So, yeah. So, I'm going to give Insidious Chapter 3 3 out of 5. It's good. It's solid. Go check it out. If you like scary movies, you're going to like this movie. It really gives you actual story to care about the characters. Now, if you did like my video, please. If you did like my video, please like my video. Does that make sense? If you enjoyed my video, please click the like button. And then comment below if you've seen this movie, because I'm kind of curious, what do you think is the best Insidious, and what do you think is the worst? I honestly think it's the second best. It's not as good as one. One was, awesome. But two was, this was good. So, what do you think? What's the best? List them in the row of what you thought, or if you haven't seen any, what are you waiting for? Anyway, Whitey out. I hope you enjoyed. Everyone have a wonderful day.